Okay, C. Lindelof videos, finding arc length. I don't want to spend too much time on this. It's actually pretty easy, I think. A couple things I want to talk about it. One is that we will definitely be using the circumference formula, which is circumference of a circle is equal to 2 pi times its radius. One of the other things I wanted to tell you is this. At this point in your career with geometry, pi is equal to pi. It's not equal to 3.14 anymore. I think that's a bad strategy. Because when you do that, you're doing something called intermediate rounding. And it's rounding before you get your final answer. So if you're using a calculator, please just use pi. And if you're not using a calculator, especially if you're in geometry or trigonometry, just leave pi as a part of your answer. Okay, we're just going to do 3 or 4 questions really quickly. So here's the first one I wanted to talk about, and all we're going to do is this. So here's the arc length that we're interested in. So we're interested in this arc length right here. And I just want to kind of make something clear. We see this angle opens here and then goes all the way around to here, right? We see this angle opens right here and goes all the way out to here. And what I'm just trying to remind everybody is that if we kept going, we'd get to 360, wouldn't we? So this is what we're going to start with. We're going to start with 2 pi. We have r is 11, right? The radius is from here to here, so there's the radius is 11 times the percent of circumference. The circumference, wow, circumference that we get. So the percent of the circumference that we get, as weird as it is 300. We get 315 degrees of the 360 degrees possible. So now this does become calculator work. So I just show you what I did here. Obviously, I put this into my calculator right here, into a calculator right here. And you can see here's the formula for radius 2 pi, r was 11, times 315 over 360. And this should be our answer. Remember, if you're doing this in pieces, you have to be super careful. So if you found the circumference first, if you did this piece first, and you would get some crappy answer, you'd get something with a decimal in it. If you round this here, that's intermediate rounding, and that's the thing you should really, really try to avoid. So whatever this value was right here, you would copy and paste it into your calculator, just carry that answer down and then multiply it by this if there was some reason you needed to do that. I would do this as one continuous string, right? There would be nothing in between. So avoid intermediate rounding. This question is the same. I'm not even going to bother doing it all for you, but we can see what we're going to do here. We're going to take 2 pi times the radius, and the radius was 13. They have to give us that, times 270 over 360, right? That's the percent that we're going to get. And when we did this math out, right, this is definitely calculator math, you'd get 61 point a bunch of crap. But we're going to round it to the tenths place, so rounded. So just to be clear, we do round. We're going to round our answers because you could get a string. You could float out to, as many values as you can imagine. But we didn't do any intermediate rounding. We only rounded at the final answer. So here's our final solution. All right, so these are a couple that are kind of more interest to people, and I'll show you why it kind of bothers people. We're going to do the same thing that we did before. We're going to take 2 pi r, and we can see clearly right here that the radius is equal to this value right here, right, this 16, so times this 16 here. But check this out. What we have to think about here is that if we went this far around the circle, we have this angular measurement in radians. So this is 3 pi halves. And if we kept going all the way around, we would get 2 pi radians. So this is really important. So we're going to do this. We're going to do 3 pi halves, right, divided by, I'm going to be careful here, divided by 2 pi, right? So I'm going to bring this down and show you what it would look like on a calculator, but just to show you here what that math would look like if you were in trig, you would just take this, you would take your 2 pi times 16, and then you would do times. So look at this. This is called theorem of complex fractions. And when you divide a fraction by a fraction, what you would do is you would take the top fraction and leave it the way it was. So here's our 3 pi halves that we had, right? I know I'm telling you what you know, but you have to kind of think this through. Otherwise, it's going to become a mess for you over 2 pi, right? Over 2 pi, which actually cleans up because pi and pi cancel, and we get 3/4 here. So if we are doing this in trig without a calculator, our answer would look like this times just 3/2. And this could actually clean up more. Right now, this should be a 16 here. Sorry, you guys. So this is a 16, right? And just to show you, I did this on a calculator. I actually did it on a calculator. And this is actually some online calculator that I used. But I type it in just like this. I did 3 pi halves, and then I divided by 2 pi, and this is what it came out looking like. But you can see it gave us this answer, and we do have a final answer that we can round, and we would round from here, so we would get 75.4. 75.4 would be our answer. Just one more quickly. In case you didn't know, this actually came off of CUDOS. Same thing, always going to find the circumference of the total circle. The total circle. So this is total circumference. Well, circumference. My pen is not following. The total circumference times percent of circumference that we get. And what percent do we get? We get pi 6 divided by 2 pi, right? This is pi 6 is the part we got. This is the part we got. This is the portion we got was right here. We're looking for this, right? This length of this arc length right here. So same thing here. We're going to do theorem of complex fractions, and we're going to do pi 6 times 1 over 2 pi. And we get that whole thing out times 2 pi times 13. Again, all calculator math, all can be done really easily. You can finish this if you want. We got a second. We really rushed through this a little bit. Times, what is it? Pi and pi cancel times 1/12. And I'd put this in a calculator just like that and only round at the very end. And I think it rounds out to the 10th place at 6.8 inches. We good? So I hope this is good. If you have any questions or comments, please let me know. If you haven't already subscribed, please subscribe.